It's hard to believe now, but a quarter of a century ago, they had to be identified as, quote, a wildly popular group of English recording stars. Then they made their American debut on the old Ed Sullivan Show, where they shared billing with the comedy team of Mitzi McCall and Charlie Brill and a tumbling group called The Four Fays. We don't know what happened to the comedy act or the tumblers, but as David Browning reports, music and life haven't been the same since the Beatles first came rocking and rolling in. Love, love me
do, you know. Where were you when the Beatles first arrived in America 25 years ago today? Debbie Leavitt was there in the crowd at the airport screaming her head off. Love
me do. First of all, I couldn't believe that we were actually here. They're standing in front of you, they're in the flesh, they're untouchable. You want to just run out of that field and you just want to grab hold of them. No,
I love you. And when the Beatles checked into the Plaza Hotel, Debbie Gendler was right there, screaming her head off.
When we heard one scream, we thought something was happening, so everyone else would start screaming. That simple.
It is impossible to underestimate the effect the arrival of the Fab Four had on American teenagers. Down south, a high school kid named Lee Atwater watched as the Beatles went on Ed Sullivan.
They influenced everything. Me and the guys I was hanging around with started trying to wear boots. And, of course, we got in a fight with our mothers real quick, particularly when we were trying to grow beetle haircuts.
I may be a little square. I don't know what beetles means.
Just means us.
Back then, the establishment couldn't figure them out. Today, beetle fans are the establishment. Debbie Gendler's in television in Los Angeles. Debbie Leavitt's a New York dental secretary. And Lee Atwater was George Bush's campaign manager. He's now the first rock and roll chairman of the Republican National Committee. And is even trying to teach the boss a guitar lick or two. Paul McCartney is getting gray, but still making music and setting off squeals. Ringo Starr appears on a TV kids show. George Harrison has a movie company. John Lennon has been gone for over 8 years now.
We had great fun, and then we had great pain and misery together. And at this stage of my life, I can look back on it and really remember the good things about it.
You can't just eliminate it for 25 years of your life. It was a part, it stayed with me, and it will always be with me.
P.S. I love you.
25 years. Rock and roll forever. David Browning, CBS News, Los Angeles.
But in the